Salutări! Suntem în penultima zi a Festivalului Internațional de Arte Performative Forma. Festivalul se desfășoară în Bastionul Măcelarilor, la Teatru 3C, organizatorul festivalului. În seara aceasta, de la ora 19, avem programat un spectacol invitat din Portugalia, Mr. Moedas Wants to See the World, și vom povesti puțin cu João García Miguel, autorul și regizorul spectacolului. Hello.
Hello. Good afternoon, yes.
Yeah, good afternoon. Yes. It's not that late yet, but it's not early either.
Yes.
Please tell us for the beginning a few words about yourself and about your theater company.
Okay. So, we are a company of theater with a special approach to performance and physical acting. I come from fine arts and music, and the relation with theater is something that it grows slowly, with interest in some other areas like dance, movement, music, and performance. So the company lives in a theater, a very beautiful theater in Lisbon, that is an old church, a 17th century old church, that the name of this place is Teatro Ibérico. We live there from 3 to 4 years now in Lisbon, and we are a voice, an alternative voice for theater in Portugal and in Lisbon in particular. And we also receive other companies, other international and national companies in our venue in Lisbon. And we perform in Portugal, Lisbon, and abroad very oftenly, namely Brazil, Angola, Mozambique, some Portuguese speaking countries, and of course in Europe, like we are now in Romania.
How is the environment for alternative creators in Portugal?
It's the environment, it's difficult, of course. It's like, I suppose, in everywhere. We have support for the national government and some support for the city halls governance also. But we need to perform and present shows all over to also keep the shows alive and make it possible to have more audiences and relate and getting related with people in different countries and different cities, because it's necessary for us to, in order to survive and make the shows last a little longer, to present it outside of Lisbon and outside of our own venue. So this circuit is not so big. There are a lot of schools, very good schools, there are a lot of good new artists, but there are not so many opportunities in Portugal for the alternative independent theater. We are now arguing with the government in order to change this landscape and to create more conditions and increase the funding. But it's a permanent battle, it's a permanent fight that we need to involve ourselves and with politicians, discussing with other agents, with other programmers, to develop the arts in Portugal. It's still a process, it's always a process. It's good, but it's a lot of sacrifices as well.
Which are the let's say main issues, main subjects that you explored so far before the show we are going to see this evening?
I'm very interested on the on this poetic, I can say it in a very broad sense, in a very open word, poetic sense of the relation with the world. Poetic in this sense that we create other meanings, other ways, other possibilities to relate with the realm, the reality, and to change reality also as in a utopian way, that it's very important for us. We, in these last 2 years, we almost dedicate the work with Portuguese authors, poets, playwrights. I also write several of the latest plays we presented, but it's also the relation with the language and the extension of the reality through the poetic approach of the art.
You're both the author and the director of this play.
Yes, in this case, yes.
Who is Mr. Moedas and how did it all start?
Well, it starts actually in Egypt, in Cairo. I traveled there and with some other programmers and artists and friends to participate in a festival, and a Dutch friend talked with me. We have an encounter, an interview, and he invited me to participate in a project that is a European project based on an idea that to discuss to a critical approach to the European commissioners of all of us, of our countries at the time. So the idea is to face our Portuguese commissioner, that is Mr. Carlos Moedas, and he have a very surprising life. He's a very brilliant character. He comes from a very poor region in Portugal. His father is a former strongly communist that is also a journalist. And then he's a brilliant student, and he get out of this place where he born, and he goes to Lisbon, then he goes to Paris, then he goes to all over the world and becomes a kind of a superstar politician, very well recognized for his skills. After a little moments of his life, he's been invited to be the Portuguese commissioner in Brussels from 2014-2019, and he have a very important role in the commission, the European Commission. Is the commissioner for the innovative and technology approach in the European Union. So he's developing a lot of project that is based on this crossing of arts, humanities, science, technology, and I talked with him.
Oh, what was his first reaction?
And the first reaction, it's difficult to talk with him. When I talk with his bureau, with his guys, the guys who are supporting him, they don't let me to be in contact with him. They avoid that we make direct contact with him. But I know someone who knows him very from his youth, and then we become in contact, very close, very intimate, and then we become, I can say, friends now. We discuss, we have this all day talking in Brussels. Give me a lot of intimate and very close and personal insights of his life and of his vision, political vision, and the work is based on this optimistic utopian and also some critical and pessimistic vision, because he have a teacher that influenced him a lot, that he talks a lot about him, that this teacher is a very special character, is almost a kind of a outcast, supposedly I can say that guy at the time, but is very influenced on his life, on the opening the world, making him see books, movies, other cities, talking about the abroad. And this situation influenced him a lot and build a lot what is his inner character in this utopian vision of life and Europe. Of course, he's also very clever and he knows that it's not so easy like that. So we have this balance between some utopian, idealistic possibility and also very critical and difficult vision, at least in my point of view. So we cross, we discuss a lot this work together, and then I isolate myself and I write text. That is the text we will present it here with Sara, an actress that I work with for a long period of time. She's a very special actress as well, very physical, very intense, very emotional actress. And I believe we build a play that is much behind the character of Carlos Moedas and is a vision of our country, of myself, a lot of people I believe with us, of Europe, of this beautiful idea that is Europe, but awful, awful pragmatical sense that the politicians made about this idealistic idea that is Europe, I believe, in the beginning. So the play is this balance between something good and something that it's not so good.
How does the play develop? Do you try to make it more engaging for the audience, adding, I know, humor, comedy, some poetic approaches? From what I saw, it's dynamic and strong somehow, like from like an image.
Like?
The images in
Yes, it's physical. It's a little bit circus. It's a little bit, of course, humoristic. It's a little bit poetic. It's also based on this intensity. It's very emotional as well. And we create a dialogue that it's based on these two characters that, in some way, they are friends, but they are also different in their age, in their visions of the world, in their relations. So we create a narrative tension that is based on this dialogue between two characters. It's more than two characters now, actually, in the end. So it's a journey inside of a person that it's in some way crossing his life and awaking some ghosts and some old memories and some visions of the future. So the play, it's like the kind of work we usually done is an appeal, but also is an attractive object, and is based on our research with movement, dance, body, music. In this case, it's very, very simple. It's the music is the music of the language. There are no other music. And Sara, it's also developing every presentation the physical relation with these two characters. So every night is a different show. Is a intense show that also based on a relation with the audience. And I believe here is the second time we will present it. As much as I saw the other days, the audience will be very close and very attached with us. At least we expect and we try to do our best. But the idea is to involve physical, even if it's almost difficult to explain how this happens, the audience with the actors. They are in both involved as a kind of a very sportive, active game.
Tell us, please, a few words about Sara Ribeiro, the actress that impersonates.
Sara is an actress that we work very long from the, I believe from the early days of Sara, because I know her in school. She has very talents for singing, for movement, and for developing is also his genuine singularity as an actress, as an artist. She's very emotional, and I believe she is the kind of actor or artist that fights every day to overcome more and more, sacrifice herself to push to have more brilliant and more extended capacity of performing. She's astonishing as what she can do, as with her voice, with her the time of the tempo of her representation, and she has been a mother recently, so I think she has now in this crossing this human growing inside of her. She's become more human, more touchy, more able to understand the others through his, this new relation with her from this new situation, because she becomes a mother, so it's something that it's very intense for her. And I think she has this fear that maybe because she's mother, she's lose something as an actress, but I believe and I feel this is the first work we do after her pregnancy, but she becomes more humble, more touchy, more intense, and more human as an artist. So Sara is a delight to the eyes to see, to perform. She's a great actress, and I believe she here, even she speaks Portuguese, but I believe the Romanian and Tirgu Mur's audience will feel the intensity of her character, of her personality in the stage.
Regarding Europe, like a topic of the show, but for yourself, which would be the main concern if you think about the future of the European Union and the future of Europe generally?
You know, it's very awkward, all the situation, because when I start this work, I don't know much about Europe. I don't know if I know a little bit more, maybe a little more, but the situation is even more difficult to have a clear stance, a clear opinion of what Europe is and what it could be in the future. But I believe that Europe gives us, as persons, as humans, a possibility to think in something bigger, and helpful, and immense, and it's good in its idea, in its idealistic and utopian purpose. But at the same time, it's so big that we as individuals feel completely drawn and smashed by this immensity. So this tension between something that it's good because it could be a kind of a mother or a father that holds you and helps you, and a grandmother or a grandfather that can help you and make you proud of something. On the other hand, it's something that it block you, and it happens a lot of situations that we are not prepared to deal with, and we don't know how to use this kind of opportunities. I know that Europe allows me to be here with you, for example, and then it's good. I feel very good to be here in Tirgu Mures to present at the show and make it a little more close to know how you live, how this extraordinary theater 3G is possible to exist and survive with all your efforts and sacrifices and capacity of being creative and imaginative, and give you my vision also from being an artist in Lisbon. And this is because Europe exists that we are here, so this is good. I believe, I feel it good at least. But on the other hand, I feel that you need a lot to sacrifice yourselves that the artists are not welcome or not, at least not well respected in Romania, not well respected in Portugal, not well respected in Europe. So there are a lot of work to do still. So Europe is a great possibility, but also a huge force that make us be more little and not so easy life on this world. So there are this ambiguity, these two forces that they fight continually, one that it's big and the other one that it's holding and make you feel very little. So I think that it's kind of a paradox, but we need to deal with this idea every day and try to find it as artists an alternative for life. We need to extend life possibilities with our work, and I believe because we are now Portuguese and Europeans and from Lisbon citizens or Tirgo Mures or whatever, we have more possibilities, even if sometimes they appear to be smaller and not so common, they're more rare. But I believe we have more, so it's up to us also to change and transform our nowadays and life every day. But I think we need to be attentive, we need to be strong in action, idealistic, but not stupidly optimistic in the end.
Okay, will the audience who come here be able to buy your book or?
Yes, we bring some books. We also have this idea to editing and publishing the book in two languages, Portuguese and English. It's a little bit unfair because we don't produce it, we don't publish in Romanian, in Dutch, whatever, but it's the thing we can do, Portuguese and English. And we try to bring it here. We cannot bring it to Netherlands, but this is the first city we can bring the book with us. And I think it's also part of the of our intention to share it and sell it if it's someone interested in listening and reading the book. Of course, we have some books that we bring with us.
Okay, that's great.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you. Welcome, and I hope to see you here tonight.
Okay, ne vedem pe seară la ora 7 cu spectacolul Mr. Moedas Wants to See the World. Iar mâine, de la ora 5, în ultima zi a festivalului, vă invităm la un spectacol lectură. E un text care se numește Celule de bază și e realizat în cadrul proiectului Culese din Telciu. Ok, deci ne vedem pe seară și mâine la 5. Salut!
It's okay?
Yes, just the microphone.